Hello, everyone, and welcome to the week number four edition of the High School Football Final. I'm Josh Stallings of WQEL and WBCO Radio. Joining me this week from Mizzic Miller is Mr. Matt Oriens from Plymel Insurance, Lee Plymel, Dean Williams of Dean's Trophy House, and Drew Rawl of Rawl Supply in Upper Sandusky. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
High School Football Final can be found on the Facebook pages of Mizzic Miller, Plymel Insurance, WQEL, and WBCO Radio, as well as Crawford County Now. Matt, why don't you give us our Week 4 Player 1?
Player 1 this week is Caleb Lohr, a linebacker from Colonel Crawford, who was instrumental in a win against Upper Sandusky. They won 46-28 this past week. Mr. Lohr had 15 tackles, one behind the line, and he returned an interception or a fumble for a touchdown, it sounds like. Yeah. Also, it sounds like he was able to perform very well after being sick all week, according to his coach. So, Caleb, my helmet sticker goes to you. Congratulations. Good job.
Okay, for our second sticker tonight, we're going to have Upper Sandusky's Mason Vent, quarterback. He went 9 of 7, 109 yards passing, 26 rushes for 194 yards with 4 touchdowns. Great performance on Friday. Mason,
good night.
Good job. Up next is the Crestline North Baltimore game. Crestline had to take a long drive up to NB, but they were able to get it done in the final seconds of the game, get the victory 33-28. Cade Ronk went off 8 of 15 passing for 117 yards. He also rushed for 184, 3 touchdowns. Then on the defensive side, 4.5 tackles, 2 picks. Go hard, son. You got the sticker this week.
Go hard, son.
So my sticker is going to Buckeye Central's Jacob Maxheimer. Jacob, although he had a tough loss against Wentford this week, nothing to do with him. I mean, he had 21 carries, 147 yards, only played half the game before he got injured or sick or whatever. But Jacob, you get my sticker for half a game, bud.
Great game. I'm headed over to the Galleon this week, and I have Braden Eccles. This young man played a great linebacker. He had 15 tackles and absolutely destroyed the River Valley's running back. So my sticker goes to Braden.
And the last sticker of the week is going to carries Connor Williams. On the offensive side as fullback, 11 carries, 29 yards, and a touchdown. Defensively, he shut down Mohawk. 18 tackles, 1 tackle for loss, and 1 interception with a small return. Great game, Connor.
Big win for Kerry.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So this week's Player of the Week, pretty easy decision. I think we were all in consensus on this one. Goes to Crestline's Cade Ronk. Cade had 117 yards passing, 184 rushing, 3 touchdowns, 4.5 tackles, 2 interceptions, all around great game. Cade, you get this plaque from Dean's Trophy House for Week 5, Player of the Week.
And remember, guys, you can get your own t-shirt, your own little sticker, and a gift card at the office of Mizzic Miller in Bucyrus and Upper.
Thanks, Lee. Also want to put a reminder out there that all helmet sticker winners throughout the week, each one of them gets invited to the banquet at Baker's Pizza. That's on November 13th. Keep playing great, guys.
Yeah, absolutely. And before we wrap up this week's show, we want to recognize our seniors from Colonel Crawford: Ethan Suter, Jordan Fenner, Evan Spangler, Dan Coker, Michael Davenbarger, Trevor Chance, and Drew Krasow. Congratulations, guys. Thanks for all you do for your schools and your community. Good luck this week in N10 play, and we'll see you again next week. You can find the High School Football Final on the Facebook page of WQEL, WBCO, Mizzic Miller, Plymel Insurance, and that'll wrap it up.
Guys.
When I feel that chill, smell that fresh cut grass, I'm back in my helmet, cleats and shoulder pads. Standing in the huddle, listening to the call, fans going crazy for the boys of fall. Didn't let just anybody in that club. Took every ounce of heart and sweat and blood to get to wear those game day jerseys down the hall. The kings of the school, man, where the boys are fall. Well, let's